Holland.
She's all honey, absolutely. Oh, she's your style. Have you got all her films, eh?
All her DVDs.
Some of them are a bit fresh, actually, aren't they?
Well, that was in 1978, but she's moved on since then.
They're a bit fresh.
I mean,
knocking out the light bulb with your shoe, you know, that's that stuff, you know. As long as get on you, the message was going daft, you know. Just leave this one at me, eh? I says, how come you never do that? She said, the big lady's all over the place.
I see, you know what your tongue's going.
I don't lost my tongue out. It's a good job at all.
I'm listening to 107. You're on the
airwaves. Listen, I'll tell you this. I promise you, Pete, this is some massive, massive mega radio station. You watch this lot blossom and bloom.
I tried to follow your wee snail trail, and then it disappeared, and now you're back in the
region.
Made my
life. Back with my snail trail. How did you hear? We're trying to keep our secret, you know. Don't go telling the audience when the clue's back. I'll just start phoning again.
I will tell everyone, I swear to God. I used to work with Susan Morrison.
Yes, wonderful.
The morning lady, brilliant.
She is so talented, and she's an awfully nice lady.
Oh, definitely.
Yeah.
I used to work with her in the company she used to work with. I'm not promoting them at all.
Absolutely not, but that's great.
Gorgeous lady, and she works somewhere else as well.
That's fantastic. No, don't mention all the
ladies.
Don't mention all the places she wants.
I just tuned in my radio. I saw a wee TV advert with you on it.
Right, I'm just imagining that, yeah.
Completely tuned in now.
You know, that's McLean on the telly.
McLean on the telly, he used to entertain me and have me in
fits. You just got a flat.
I
told
the doctor to get my medication.
I said, stand by. I'm going to get one or two nutcases on here, so you better get your medication right.
You still got your bonnet?
Of course I've got my bonnet. I'll tell you, you don't think I was going to come to Edinburgh without a hat? I wasn't going to wear my old Bobby's helmet. Oh, no. I've been away down south.
Oh, no.
Oh, I've been in Yorkshire. I've been in the northwest of England. Been in Yorkshire twice. Been in Newcastle. You know, it's all that kind of stuff. And then I came back up and they put me on in Glasgow. You know, and then somebody came along and bought the station. I think they'd be home to get McLean the cheap.
Bought the station, keep the videos and education.
I bought the station. So that was that. So that's it. So the studio's on. And I came here to Top 107, and it's the best thing I've ever done in my life.
Definitely, because I've been through you twice before.
Yeah,
you won't remember our problems anyway.
Remember your problems. It was your problems that started mine.
I couldn't forget
your problem. I'm still saving up to pay for them. I started a charity for you.
Oh, you've still got a big man. You've still got it.
It's called Pear Sounds. And I've got a lot of money together.
I'm not paid up anyone.
Yourselves.
It's
better than £10, isn't it? I'll tell you, I've got all that together for you, and everybody's giving generously. I was talking to the auditors, you know, who are very distinguished accountants, and I said to them, how much is in Pearsall's account so that I can give something to Pete for it? He said, we'll just do a wee recce up there, Scotty. He said, right, that's it, and they came back. Do you know how much they've got for you?
£9.36.
That's me been out for a fortnight singing. He says, who gave you the six? I says, they all did. I told the missus when she was chasing away the crowd.